There we go. So, hey, I don't think I like the camera there for this. I don't think I like it there at all. That's better. Let's see here. Coffee mug. Fine. Eh, it's fine. Okay. No, because now I'm out. Better? I think it's better. Okay. Whatever. Alright, so. Hi, Seaberry. Nice to see ya. We're playing Minecraft. So here's the deal. We're playing modded Minecraft. I'm in creative mode. I really have cheats turned on, so I'm not 100% creative mode. But I am effectively in creative mode. Because I have no shame. Alright. So let me show you what we're working on here. Actually, faster way back home. No? There we go. This is our base. It's meant to look kind of future-y. I didn't do a great job. The idea was I was trying to emulate, like, the runes on here. This was a bit of a hack job, I'm not gonna lie. In fact, I don't think I need these anymore because of all the glowstone. So let's get rid of these. Yeah, it's still plenty bright in here. Alright. Here's my bed. Here's the house. Here's the attic. It's where we have activities. Anyway, I haven't done much in my house. Before I show you our current project, let me show you the projects I've done off stream. One is this super smelter, which, admittedly is a little slow. It hasn't quite gotten to the point where everything's smelting. But it looks like a nice little brick house from here. I'm wondering if I should put little... I don't know, part of me thinks I should put the other tie up there. I'm not sure, so... any input's appreciated. If you think we should have the ties on top, let me know. I don't know, the ties on top I think are kind of nice, but... they're also a little bit... weird aesthetically with some things. Anyway. So, the front part's just the smelters. Back here. Well, no. Let's show you the other operational door. This is the other operational part. In here, smeltables, fuel. Great. Okay. And I realize that this entire build could have been done in vanilla. I don't care. I like it. If we go back here, you can actually see how it's running. We have two mine carts. This one is the smeltables cart. It goes up. Goes over these. Whoa! Oh, thank you for the raid there, Chuck! You didn't have to come on over, but I'm glad you did. So over here is the smeltables track, and over here is the fuel track, which is much, much smaller. So that's a project we already finished. I did that one alone. Meanwhile, we come over here. This is the cobble road. I tried to make sure that it had moss on the parts that are touching water. Because aesthetically, I find that pleasing. Down there's our nether portal. We're not really doing anything with that right now. But if we come up here, this is the hub. This is our hub waystone. And this is the oaken road. So the oaken road... you know what? One second, everyone. I need to fix something. Haha. safe. Alright, just refreshing my chat reader, because I realize it did not highlight that raid. If it wasn't for the noise, I wouldn't have heard it. Which is a shame. Okay. So we're in here. So this is the oaken road, which I think I need to add more of these lamps. The yellow road has a functional railroad. The oak road does not yet. But I think the oak road's railroad is not going to go through the tunnel. Alright. So this is our tunnel. I've hollowed out most of the tunnel already. So this is a little palette I used to show Chuck what I was thinking. Because I was mentioning it. No problem, Chuck. I showed it to Chuck, see what he thought, now that I got more people in the chat. So we have it in dark. The other train of thought I was thinking, though, was... Let's see where this one is. This guy. Boop. But does it look better in the dark? Or does it look better in the light? That is an important question here. Now, do I like the redstone lanterns with the orange? I do like it with the orange. I'm not sure if I want to keep the orange or maybe do another color. Because I was also thinking dark with orange looks nice. But what if? What if? That's the important part. What if? Where are my glass panes? Cave crystal. No. We want glass planes. What if we did it with blue? So dark and orange, light and blue. There's also something to be said for dark and blue. But I think dark and orange is a good pair. Plus, also, we're using a lighter oak for our archways. I think the darker wood will give us a better look there. Also, it is insane how much watching Surge play Minecraft has infected me playing Minecraft. Now the other question is this plank or this plank? I think this plank. Yeah, that plank is better. Alright. Now, doing this kind of wall does mean I'm gonna have to do a couple more redstone circuits, but I don't have the attention span to play in survival. I'm in creative, so that's not the worst thing in the world. And yes, I realize I could use the always lit lamps, but I don't want to. Playing creative doesn't feel like I'm cheating, but using creative only assets, at least in this type of project, does. If you think this is bad, you do not want to see what I have going on in the other modded Minecraft thing I have running. That is also using a lot of creative mode to be functional. Over there, I'm trying to drain a huge chunk of the nether using buildcraft. Yeah. And then, let's see here. Something that I have been considering is doing, and I realize that this is going to sound like I'm in 2010, but I've been considering doing Minecraft sketches. Well, a bunch of video game sketches, but I was thinking, like, you know, doing Minecraft 1 specifically. And making it a riff on the predecessor to HGTV, which is this old house. Which, oh man, I could go for some this old house. And it's weird, I hated it as a child. But I think that's because I was a kid and Power Rangers was on. And now I'm an adult and Netflix exists, so Power Rangers is always on. Oh, that reminds me. I really need to do another art stream in the near future. And I realize art streams are more Red's area, and I don't want to take that from them. but I also draw, and I need to remind myself that my art is just as valid as Red's. And that's not a dig at Red, that is me trying to boost myself up. Because something I've been playing around with the idea of, most of my family lives super far away, so in order to visit them I have to go on super long car rides. And if I have to go alone, which I've had to a few times, and I never enjoy it. We should do a server together sometime, Chuck. I agree. I've been playing Minecraft since way back in the alpha. I remember Cheese Sponge. I remember when it was a browser game. Like, when I first played it, I played it for like a week as a browser game. Before I did anything else. To see if I really wanted to invest in this crazy Java version they were introducing. Ooh, ah. I mostly like it to get ideas out of my head. Anyway, the idea I was having that it would require me drawing, as most of you who watch know, one of my favorite shows, or franchises rather, of all time is Kamen Rider. I mean, that's not to say I don't still like Super Sentai, Power Rangers, Transformers, etc., but I just really like Kamen Rider. There's something very fun about the fact that the entire setup is dark. But it's always it's almost always a story of light and hope. When it stops being that, I tend to get disinterested, because I don't like the edgelordy ones. And I also disagree with some writer fans. I think Ghost is fine. I don't think it's great. I think it could have been better. But I notice a lot of writer fans who hate Ghost. Also, I hate Steven Universe. And I think Ghost and Steven Universe fill the same place for me as well. But not a place of derision, but rather a place of, I wish this was better, but it's still pretty good. Steven Universe is better on the pretty good side. But I know some people go like, no, Ghost is a flawed concept, it never would work. It's like, no, it could have worked. Anyway, but you also know I love Magic. So, Magic the Gathering. That's how I met Chuck. So one thing I was thinking of doing was, what would it look like if we took writer logic and applied it to the Gatewatch? Because why not? They are both very much toyetic design characters. And it's an insane concept, but like, as for like what each one would be called, I have no idea. Like, we can't just call them by their color. First off, Liliana's color has already been taken by another Kamen Rider. So, that doesn't work. But, I was thinking maybe they're home planes? Or maybe just give them their own names, and then have them be like, their armor, or whatever their power-up for the season would be based on their home planes. I don't know. Or maybe make it based off of the iconic creatures? Maybe that's the mid-season power-up. I've had ideas, and I've been playing with the concept of what would a magic-themed writer series be. Or maybe it'd be completely unrelated people with powers based on the Gatewatch. If that's the case, I don't want to run into the inevitable writer villain who would be based on Bolas. Sorry, I'm talking about, like, multiple fandoms that should not touch. And I recognize that. Okay, so yeah, we're hollowing out this whole thing. And the problem is that we built this into a mountain. So there's a lot going on that I have to, like, build around. Okay, so, you know what, before we continue to chisel this out, let's go back to the beginning here. Alright. Now that we have a design, in fact, let's do the design over here. So, we're using that wood. We're going in 1, 2. And then orange window. And then next frame. Yeah, okay. So we want a little bit of symmetry going on here. And then these come back here. Okay, and then we go behind it. Boop, boop. And I do not remember what my wiring setup was. I remember it took me like 20 minutes to get it right. It was just... it was bullshit. Let's go look over here. It was... bottom corner, middle top corners. Okay. Bottom outside, middle insides. Got it. Okay. And some of these walls are going to be more difficult than others to set up because we're going to have to build floors for things, and I don't want to do that. But we're going to have to. Why not just use levers? Levers for what? You mean instead of the redstone torches? I don't want them to ever be off. As for why not use levers to get behind there, I think my biggest problema was I didn't want to really mess with levers, and I realized that probably would have been the smarter way to do it. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that the lamps are in, it is darker. And dick-a-doop. There we go. So yeah, I didn't use levers because I just don't want them off. Okay. Then we're going to use this on the floor. There we are. Oh wait, there's a way to do this. Control for extras. Sneak click on block to select, right click to exchange. Okay. There we go. And now I need to do the ceiling. Which I think the ceiling might be done well with that. Oh, wait a minute. I have the exchanger. That'll make this so much easier. Dang it. It's like, this is basically the look I want for the oak tunnel. I like the braided wood down here, and I like the rustic, pallety look up here. Feels like it leads into a hipstery coffee shop. Alright, we're going to try a Chuck's way now. Because he's insisting this will work. And it probably will. Because I'm bad at Minecraft and video games in general. Let's see if this is true. mean, to be fair, that is much easier than doing it the other way. So, just for, you know, completion's sake, I think that is the way to go. Oh, I could just do it like that even. Nice. Okay, because this side is what matters. Dang it. Why did you not turn on? Because I didn't put a switch on you. Okay, yeah, that looks good too. Alright, no, we're doing it Chuck's way. Chuck's way is actually a lot easier. Because I can actually get away with, like, just a one thing back here. And I'm okay with that. Alrighty. So let's get to work on the walls, I guess? No. Let's go back to clearing out everything. But now we have a proof of concept of where we're going with... Do I need the torches? Yes. Okay. So this part's pretty much cleared out. Now that I know I can use the replacer, I'm not as worried about the floor or the ceiling. It's the walls we need to worry about because we're doing a design. Okay, so we just gotta start digging out. Oh, that's why I'm playing in peaceful mode right now, Seabury, because I am what the scientific community calls a coward. I will eventually turn enemies back on, but they were getting in the way of a couple of my builds. Rats. Okay. So... Chat? Oh, no, there it is. Whoop, whoop. Okay. And whoop. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I destroyed my 5. There we go. And, you know what, I mean, this is just me digging and hanging out. Treat this as a just chatting stream. If you want to talk. Ooh. Ooh, I did not consider those, Chuck. Thank you. That's why it's fun to have other people here. Because that helps you bring in other ideas and opinions that you wouldn't have had otherwise. That was from when I was going to make everything braided, and I realized that that would just be ugly AF. And nobody needs that in their life. Boop. Okay, so... And then torch... For now, we're going to use torches, but I think later we are going to replace them with those nice hanging candles Chuck just mentioned. That sounds like a really good idea. Where is the Infinna Harvester? Dang it, I knew it would happen. I knew it. Also, dang it. Okay. That's better. Okay, so I still need to do a little bit more redstone work than I want to. Oh, right, so that end, obviously, was my base. Over this end is a very weirdly spawned village. And the reason we're using the braided wood is that's what I started using for the floors. Now, I did lock all the villagers in, as a good neighbor would. There's the well. And it's honestly a little dumb that I made the whole, like, road and I'm doing the whole thing. But there's a reason for that. And the reason is because this has gardens and I thought it'd be nice. But there is something about this village. Its highest point is another waystone. So this whole road is honestly pointless, but I thought it would be nice. And then there's just so many gardens in this village. And a lot of them are just not connected to any... How did you get out? Ugh. Get in your house, villager. Get in your house. 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 That's what you get for not getting in your house, I guess. Murder. Murder is what you get. Yeah, it spawned like this. I don't know why. Not the roads. The road... Whoa. I fell into the tree. What? Oh, neat. Falling damage damages leaves in this mod. That's cool to know. But yeah, so I added the road here, but like, it just spawned with some things here. A couple of houses didn't have doors, or the doors just went into a cave wall. So the big thing I added was one... Get that out of here. One, I added this staircase, which is very, very large. And very, very long. But it was okay, because I was having a nice conversation with my friend Rachel while it was happening. Who I need to talk more to. Anyway, and then I brought it up to here, brought it over to here. What is that? Cold grass. That's cool. And then I had a conversation with my mom about her new computer, which is rainbowy. She likes her rainbowy computer. Anyway, oh, right, I didn't actually put steps up yet. Oh, well. So, yeah, so at least this village, which I thought was weird, and I thought it was nifty. And so I'm trying my best. Ooh. Okay, this one's going to be different. Nope. Boop, 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 boop. Do, 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 do. What do you think, chat? 3x2 window? Or 1x2 window? You know, I think 3x2. 3x2 is the way to go here. Ooh, but wait. How do we 3x2? Well, I guess the best way to 3x2 is close that off. Okay. Let's see here. Would that be just one lever in the middle? There we go. Yeah. Actually worked out really, really well. Let's look at it. Pretty good. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Then over on this side. Also, I like that the window's a little sunken in. It gives it a dynamic look. Nice. Okay, so this entryway is good. this whole chunk is going to be absurd. Of that much I am certain. Let's see here. So there is what, 5 here? So from this one I need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I fell down a hole somehow. Let's see here. Boop. Okay. If I measured that right. Digging straight this way should, yep, get us to that log. Fantastic. So we're making a very weird tunnel to go to the very weird village. But I think that's fine. And you think it's going to be a very pretty tunnel when we're all done? And then that brings up the bigger question of, do we put the railway in it? Or do I do a railway around the outside to the other end of the village? Because part of it is, I want to make that if this turns into like a land thing, that it is accessible for the friends I invite into this server. And this isn't in a server right now, but I imagine I'd be able to export the map eventually. Once that's viable, you know? That's much better. Okay. And I just realized, again, I could have done that an easier way. Now this one is also a 2x3 window, I think. No. Okay. So how's everybody doing? Oh, dang it, I didn't go deep enough. Now, wait a minute. Did we just discover a way to make this faster? Perhaps. Okay, so let's try it on this one. Let's see here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. So this one's actually a little bit too long. Okay. Then if this is too long, let's put in these first. And give this a try. Okay. Okay, so we go boop, boop. Great. Now what if we went to... Oh no, did I lose my replacer? I think I did. Let's find it in here. Dang it. That is much faster. Okay. Well, then this changes everything. Well, not really. There are some places I'm still going to have to build the walls by hand, because I already replaced them. But other places, I won't have to, because I didn't yet. Okay. We are, like, making very quick room of this. Quick room? I don't know why I said it that way. Okay, we're getting somewhere now. Doop-de-doop. There we go. Okay. I am liking this. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, right. Okay, it's not a perfect solution, but we're just gonna do that. Great. Done. Print it. Whoops. Okay. Let's get rid of all this stuff. Yeah, all right. I think we're getting somewhere now. As for what inspired me to do this, that would be eons ago. By that I mean like last year, or 2 years, a little over a year ago. Skippy, Jacob, Skippy the Wonder Chicken, and I were doing some Minecrafty stuff. So was Mikella, and he made a really cool sandstone tunnel. And I thought of it recently. Being like, man, I missed that sandstone tunnel. Because it was really neato. So I thought maybe an oaken tunnel would look just as good here. I don't know, seemed like a good idea. Alrighty. Put that braided wood back in our inventory so that we might have a place to put things. Alright. See here. Okay. So Alright, so I think we're good on getting the tunnel cleared. Okay, and there we go. That wasn't too bad. Okay, yeah. There we go. Oh, that looks very good, actually. So just already our entryway, if we're coming in from this angle, looks great. Let's kill out all this stuff. Oop.
boop, 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 boop. Boop, boop.
And now for a new problem. When we're done, we're gonna have to cover up the outside of the tunnel. Because you'll notice there's chunks here and chunks here that we don't necessarily want people seeing. But for now, we're just going to keep moving forward. Yeah, let's glass this up. Great. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Boop, 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 boop. Very nice. Boop. Wonderful. I think we're getting there. I think this is going to be an amazing thing when we're all done with it. At the very least, it's going to be a very fun thing to travel through, which is its purpose. Alrighty. Oh. Boop, boop, boop. Okay. That almost ended poorly. Alright, so like the first three column chunks are done. I'm happy with that. I need more water. Mm-mm. That's the other thing I have to get used to, is I do not have my wrist rest anymore. That thing got too flat, so I'm not using it. Where did I miss? The ceiling. Oh, there it is. Boop. Great. Okay, and then... Sound like that. The windows are too close together that way. I think alternating which side that they're too high. Now, wait a minute. Oh, dang it. I measured my pins wrong. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. Yep. Sure enough, that's what I did. Like, I could fix it all the way down this way, but at that point, I don't know, everything else got measured by 9 except for that one section. And I guess over here. So in the meantime, let me just do over here. Okay, and then here. Ooh. So this pillar looks like he belongs, he just doesn't connect to another one. Which I guess is what happened over here. That's fine. We're cheating. That's what we're doing. We are cheating to make this look better. That's fine as well. You're more than allowed to cheat if it works for the overall aesthetic of what you're doing. There we go. In fact, what we might do is then do like one cross-hatching log that way. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is looking really nice now. I think it is, anyway. That's what matters, because it's my Minecraft server. So, meh. This one won't have a window or a thing, and that's fine. And then let's get some of them planks and yeah. Okay. Perfect. Like to do. So I'd like to set up a little piston wall right here that comes off of this guy. If I just had, say, this, why do I have wheat? All right, let's stash some stuff. Wheat can go, char can go, flint and steel don't need you. Diamond sword's fine. Planks, crag, stone, nailed planks. There we go. Let's just get a sticky piston in here. Just a simple redstone circuit. Redstone circuit? Yeah. Okay. Okay. I can live with that. I think we're getting somewhere with this. Over on this side. Okay. Alrighty. And what we have here is actually nope. What I would like is to make it that we had a place to do the redstone door for this side, because what I want to do now is once we're done with this side, make it so that this tunnel goes all the way through behind. One, two. It's about to spit me out into a cavern. Yep. Cavern, all right. So, making it so that all of them have a place to attach, I think, will help with making everything even. And then there's going to be getting rid of this, like, chimney thing, which doesn't even lead anywhere. There's, like, nothing up here. So, in fact, might be a good idea right now would just be fill this in so nobody gets tempted. We don't need anybody getting tempted around here. Yes, Chuck. I'm sorry. I didn't notice until earlier that this was, that you asked. This is Surgecraft that we are using right here. So Surgecraft is Serge Jaeger's mod set that one of his mods put together for him to use with Minecraft. And I'm not using the same skin he is, so my stream's going to look a little different. But I have access to all the same tools he does right now, at least for Minecraft. Like, yeah. So I want to have some kind of rear tunnel. That way I can access all of the light controls from behind. Yep. Okay. I mean, they're little tunnels, but they're basically Jeffrey's tubes. So that's understandable. A Jeffrey's tube are the they're the name that you give to the tunnels, the maintenance tunnels, throughout Federation-class starships in Star Trek, which I found out by watching Voyager with Red. Side. There we go. It's not too bad. Ooh. I am suddenly very fatigued. It might be because it's 7 o'clock. I've been up for hours and hours and hours. But I think that is some good headway on that. I still owe you guys the character making Pathfinder stream if people are actually interested in that. So make sure you shoot stuff at me on Twitter if you want me to do pre-gen character making and DM advice on stream. If that's something that you want from somebody who's been GMing longer than half his life. By that I mean me. Yeah. If that's something you want, please let me know. I might just do it for myself, but it's much better with questions to answer, I think. But for right now, I think that was fine. Good reasonable stream to get back on my feet with. I act like I'm old. I've been told my whole life I'm older than I should be. Sounds about right. I mean, yeah, I've been GMing for 16 years. Started middle school. That's well over half my life. I'll tell you, it takes you 7 years to become an expert at something. I've done more than twice that. So, I'm twice the expert, I guess. I don't know. Honestly, it's just a lot of, like, reading and improv skills. But it's good. I mean, I'm no famous DM like Matt Mercer, but I said that's snottier than I wanted to. Matt Mercer's a really nice guy, and he doesn't deserve that kind of lip from me. Who the heck do I think I am? But yeah, so there's that. But as of right now, I feel very old, because I'm very tired. And also, mildly sick still. And I want to be good for work tomorrow, so I should probably call this quits, he said as he continued mining and crafting. So yeah. If you like this, make sure you do the whole follow button thing. Do the like, the comment, subscribe over on Facebook. Like I said, a lot of improv and reading. If you're not ready for everything, you're not improving right. If your improv sessions do not involve somebody yelling grenade at some point, I don't know what kind of improv sessions you're doing. Probably more traditional ones than me. Yeah, no. Improv and reading. That's the name of my memoirs. No. Yeah, so, ooh. We are nearly done tiling the walls, at least. So I think I'll finish tiling the walls. I want two scoops to come back. That's entirely up to me. I recognize that. So this one just got extra short somehow. Oh, well. So two scoops will be back sometime soon. I don't 100% know when yet, but it won't be too long. We still have a lot to talk about with, like, Modern Horizons. Deck boxing I would also like to bring back, but last time we realized there were some issues with how we had it formatted, and I think, even though I was having a lot of fun with the league, there are some things I need to balance out. First, yeah. And then, yes, war for the spark with planeswalkers in every pack. That got me hyped, honestly, but I think that's because I like how planeswalker cards work. And I can see where people are very concerned. I think that's the best way to put it. Some people are very, very concerned about there being so many planeswalkers available for the common man. And I can understand why they would be concerned about that. Because planeswalker cards can make or break a game. They're not always the most powerful. In fact, very rarely will they actually win you the game. But the powerful ones are powerful. It's going to mess with standard. It's really going to mess with standard. And what we're going to see is, yeah, we're going to see a lot of people playing planeswalkers at the pre-release. And I think, personally, what I think is about to happen is we are going to see a set with planeswalkers matters. And I don't know if this is going to go, like, Journey into Nyx with enchantments matter, or if it's going to be closer to Mirrodinning Kaladesh with artifacts matter. And I mean, they figured out most of the problems with artifacts matter, but planeswalkers matter has its own issues. One of those issues being, oh god, what is it called? Yeah, before I do that, let's take you over to the Slime Garden. That might be fun. Oh no, you know what? Let's do a tour of the Waystones first. Now this is, No, let's do this first. So this is the Yellow Brick Road. You have to start it. You have to come over here and then nudge yourself. And this is a roadway, and this takes us to our furthest west waypoint, which is Slime Garden. And I realize it's dumb to do this to a place where there's a waypoint, but the advantage to this is you can throw down a chest cart, and then send it forward. You know, I think I might just do this. We'll do a little tour before we end. Still do the like, comment, subscribe thing. And still think of any D&D or Pathfinder questions that you would want answered in a stream about that. Because, though it's not the way I wanted it, and I'm still happy I got it, I might be starting a new day job that will not replace the other day job yet. That's still going to be a thing for a little while. But it might lead to something better, which will be good. And it does mean that on the regular, and getting paid for it, I will be able to play Pathfinder, a couple other games, and Magic with kids. which will be great because it's running after school programs. I'm very excited about that. And it's going to replace the volunteer work I was doing that same thing. So it's like volunteering, but I get paid now, which will be nice. So what that means for me is that basically I am going to be playing a lot more stuff, and it's going to be great, and it's going to be good for my mental health. And it's going to get more kids into playing games, which sounds like something kids wouldn't have a hard time with, but typically if a game's not super popular, you don't see a lot of kids playing it. This is Slime Garden. Slime Garden is a slime island, one of our two slime islands, and this is Slime Garden West. One thing I love about slime gardens. Bouncies. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go as high up as possible and see what the bounce limit is on this blue slime. But yeah, so Planeswalker Matters, I'm a little bit concerned about. Because it also affects historic. Because all Planeswalkers are legendary. Boing. Boing. And as they are legendary, that also makes Mox Amber much stronger. Knowing that people will have an easier time getting access to legendary cards. Okay, so these are waypoints. Waypoints get us two things. So we are going to go to... So these two are our main ones. We are currently at Slime Garden West. Oh wait, no. Get down here. As a crester. Okay, so the hub you've seen, alchemy base you've seen. Let's go, and I think Mokrasark is the village. Yes, Mokrasark is the village. This is Slime Garden 1. I don't have a path leading to here yet. But the Slime Garden is one. I think it has a pool of slime that leads to the ground. Hey, what is this? What is this? What did you drop? These slime balls. Ooh. That's fun. No. This one I did not cut through the bottom of. I don't think I did. Let's find out. No. A couple of the other slime islands I did cut through their bottom. I did not do that on this one, apparently. Mokrasark is over that way. My render distance is actually very, very low. Let's fix that. Video... Let's bump up our render to 16. Okay, and this is gonna make things much slower. I always drop it when I have to go to the Nether. Because my computer lags when I have to go to the Nether horribly. Okay, so that's Slime Garden. Lukakrark is another one. This is where the brick road is going to go. So this is south of our base. Yes, I purposely lock the villagers in. I am a cruel, uncaring person. And I am not at all done fixing up their road yet. This is going to be the brick road. And the brick road's going to, of course, lead back to the base. We have Azacrester, which is a desert town with all this beautiful red desert. And where is this, comparatively? Let's zoom out a little bit and find out. So that's not Slime Garden, that's a different one. Because Slime Garden is here. So this is not the further, this is further south. But this is southeast as opposed to directly south. Because this is Mokrasark, and this is the plains, and over here is Azacrester. Yeah. All right, and then we're going to go back over to here, and then we have Razoiris. And Razoiris, where are you, Razoiris? I want to say Razoiris is so far away. Yes, here we are. Rhizoiris is the furthest east we've been, or west we've been, even further west than Slimegarten. To the point of I'm actually considering making a second blue road that goes from Slimegarten to out here. This was for me exploring. I have not fully explored north yet. Of course, you can't fully explore Minecraft. That's how it works. But I've not gone further north than Slimegarten yet. Oh, wait, that's not true. Where is... This is... No? Where's my base? There we go. So this is Slimegarten. So there is something up here. I just haven't found what's up there yet. Okay. But for right now, we're going to go back to... let's go back to Slimegarten West. And hit that. And we'll take our way back. We'll see how bad increasing our render distance messes with the lag. Now, my eventual plan is to extend this out to 5 feet wide, add a guardrail, and like two walkways, maybe just one walkway. I might do it like a walkway on that side. I'm not 100% sure yet. But yes, so who's that? I'm excited for war. We'll talk about that more when we get two scoops going up again. Part of it is I gotta clean up this table and replace it with the other table, because we don't have a lot of room, which is a problem. I'm gonna be doing a lot of D&D talk, Pathfinder talk, and I need to make... The reason I was talking about the job is I need to make character sheets for the kids, because I've come to the conclusion that making pre-made characters is the way to go for new kids who come in who have never played before, because that'll give them a feel for the game before they decide if they want to do it or not. Same with the welcome decks for Magic. If they like the welcome decks, then we're not out that much. If they don't like the welcome decks, well then, we're out of luck. But then they won't like Magic, and it won't matter. But they probably will like Magic, because this is a good game. But with Pathfinder, you have the character sheet, and then that way also, if your character dies, you don't feel like you've lost all this time and effort. Because it was my time and effort. And then I just hit a button on the copier, and you have a new one. Done. Right now, since we're at a library, I'm using the librarian class. But why are you done? Did we run out of smeltables already? I think we did. Oh, Jesus. There has got to be a better system for moving these. Okay, you know what we need? We need a backlog. So we're going to use this. We're going to use this. Wait, this is Surgecraft. There is a clipboard in here. Clip. Thank you. Clipboard. Wait. There we go. Okay, so. To-do list. Finish oak tunnel. I think that's fair. Finish oak tunnel. Finish yellow road. Okay. Fix storage system. Because we need a better storage system than we've been using. We've just been placing chests everywhere. Find northern village. I abbreviated the wrong word. Find north village. Find east village. Build brick road. Build blue road. Build east road. And then I think we're just going to focus on these things for now. But one more. just to be safe. I think that's good for now. Do I hit enter? No. Do I click? Nope, nope. Enter. Nope. Okay, it's escape. So, hey, we got our little to-do list here, and we can put it in our offhand. All right, that's the F button, isn't it? G, H, R, R. No. Oh, what is that? Waypoints? Oh, that's neat. But for now, yeah, I think we're done for now. So a lot of neat things. We will be back to Minecraft later. Not today. Yeah, good, okay. Not today. New? That's right, I just found it. What? Nope, that's the journey map. Z. Caps lock, no. Okay, fine. Okay, fix house. There we go. That's a good one. For now, let's sleep. And that'll be it for today, I think. That's right, there's emotes. Anyway, thank you for joining me. I appreciate everyone who comes to watch, everyone who comes to follow, everyone who raids, etc. It's always great. Yeah, we'll have more shows in the future, because that's how we do things around here. Hope you all have a wonderful day.